Hi everyone, this is Sunny Kumar from Mathematics and Computing Part 2 from IIT BHU, and I am back again with HackerEarth February Easy Problems, and the problem name is Allies and Candies. So let's jump directly into the problem statement. So this problem says that we have been basically given an integer n that Allies wants exactly n candies. So we have to basically find the number of different sets of candy packets that Allies can buy. Note that all the packets contains an odd number of candies, that is 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, and Allies wants exactly n candies, and she loves that pattern, okay, 1, 3, 5, 7. So we have to find. Also, there are also one more condition, as you can see here, the packets that Allies would be choosing would be consecutive and distinct, that is, the packets that she can choose would be like, suppose Allies has to build 45 and she has to build the 45 number from the consecutive packets. Also, the packets numbers must be distinct, that is, either she can choose 5, 7, 9, 11, 13. Note that this sum is exactly equal to 45 and the sum is consecutive. The elements are consecutive and the sum is 45. Also, the elements are distinct. And again, you can see here also the sum is 45 and the elements are distinct and the elements are consecutive also. And one thing you can note that their absolute difference would be exactly 2, that is, the numbers are of the form 1, 3, 5, 7. So what are the number of different sets of candy packets that Allies can buy? Note that n can vary from 1 to this huge amount. Also, we have to find out the number of different ways that Allies can represent n as different sets of integers of the form 1, 3, 5, 7, such that she can buy the different packets. Okay, so how we are going to approach this question? So let us understand this. Okay, so now one thing you can notice that 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 up to the nth odd number. So the first n numbers sum would be always be represented by a number called n square. So if you have to represent the first sum of first two odd numbers, that is 1 plus 3, that is always going to represent by n square, that is 2 square, that is 4. So what I am going to do is, we have to represent n as sum of the consecutive numbers which are odd, as well as their difference is 2 and the elements must be distinct. So what I am going to do is, I am going to write two statements, that is, okay, sum of first n two odd numbers minus sum of first n one odd numbers. Okay, so note that n can be always be represented as n two. Let me write n two square minus n1 square. You can also verify from it here that here you can see that is 5 plus 7 plus 9 plus 11 plus 13. So okay, let me write it here also. Okay, 5, 7, 9, 11 and 13. Note that this sum can be written as, so our it would be our first, let me write here some briefly. Okay, 1 plus 7 plus 9 plus 11 plus 13. So for up to 13 I have sum of first 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. So our sum of first 7 numbers, that is 7 square, minus sum of first 2 numbers, that is, you can see 3 plus 1. So you can write here also 2 square, that is going to 49, minus 4, that is 45. Okay, so it is giving 45 as our answer. So we can always write sum of first, we can always write sum of consecutive elements sum as n2 square minus n1 square, where n2 is going to denote sum of first n2 odd numbers starting from 1, and n1 is going to denote sum of first n1 numbers, n1 odd numbers starting from 1. Note that I am going to write here condition, that is, n2 is always greater than n1. Okay, so let me solve this also. N2 plus N1 into n2 minus n1. Okay, so n can always be represented as the product of this. Now what we have, what I am going to do is I am going to factorize, let me write here clearly, find the divisor of capital N such that N can be represented as product of two numbers. Okay, now suppose I have N here as 45. So 45 can be represented as 1 into 45, or let me say 3 into 15. Okay, or we can also write here as 5 into 9. Also we can write it as 15 into 3. Also we can write it as 9 into 5. Also we can write it as 45 into 1. So you can see these are the valid combinations that we can obtain. Note that, let me show our product n2 plus n1 and n2 minus n1 can be written as, let me say, okay, suppose we have here 1 into 45. So what we can do is we can write n2 plus n1 into n2 minus n1 as 1 into 45. So either our n2 plus n1 would be equal to 1, or our n2 minus n1 should be equal to 45. So these are the cases, or we have the reverse also, n2 plus n1 can be equal to 45 and n2 minus n1 can be equal to 1. Note that this is going to happen in latter case, that is when we take 45 into 1, this condition, that is 45 is going to be up in case of n2 plus n1, this will be automatically going to happen. Okay, so this we need not to worry about that. So in this case, what I am going to do is I am going to add these two equations. So our new equation would be like 2 n2, that must be equal to a plus b. Let me denote it as a, and let me denote it as, okay, b. So our new equation would be n2 equal to a plus b. So this clearly signifies that n2 can be written as a plus b by 2. And similarly, n1 can be written as a minus b by 2. Note that for this to satisfy, the parity of a and b must be same. So that is, a and b must be odd, or a and b must be both even. So that then only in that case we can perform this division. Suppose okay, a and b both are odd, then this would become even, and a and b both are even, then this will be divided by 2. Okay, so this is, so basically we have approached the answer, that is we have to find n1 comma n2 such that n2 is greater than n1, and n1 is going to vary from 0 to some less than n2, and n2 is going to vary from 1 to some capital integer n. So we have to find pairs of n1 and n2 that is giving the solution, that is going to be valid pair. Or note that a and b, let me write here as one condition, parity of a and b must be same, that is both even or both odd. Okay, so this is the main logic behind this question. We can always write n as sum of first n2 odd numbers minus sum of first n1 odd numbers, so you will get this result. Note that you need not to worry about a and b, this will be automatically managed later, because any number can be written as 1 into 45 can also be written as 45 into 1. So let me approach to the code. Okay, so first I have taken the n, that sum we need to be obtained. So what I have done is I have find the divisors of n, that is from 1 to square root of n, and if n is going to be divided by I, that is if now I have, what I have done is I have taken Note that n can always be represented as product of two numbers. That is, if n is divisible by I, then our other number is b, that is going to be n by I. Now I have here checked that if a and b both are of same parity, that is both are either even or both are either odd. Now again, if this condition holds, what I have done is I am going to check if I comma n by I, that is, you can also write here is a comma b. If a comma b is a valid pair, then I am going to increment my answer as 1. Again also I am going to check here that b, okay, if a comma b is a valid pair, my answer would be incremented by 1. Again I am going to check if b comma a is also a valid pair, then it is also correct that we have to increment our answer by 1. Note that I into I must not be equal to n, otherwise we are getting count as 1 extra, because suppose 36 is a perfect square, then when we encounter add 6, then suppose 36, then in this case our I would be 6, n by I is also 6, then I am going to count, if this is a valid pair, I am going to count it twice. That's why I have written this statement, I into I must not be equal to n, so that extra pair should not be counted. So in this case also I am going to increment my answer. So what is valid pair? So let me introduce you with that also. So I am going to calculate n2 as a plus b by 2. That is, if n, capital N, can be represented as the product of two numbers, and again n1 as a minus b by 2, and if n1 is greater than 0, note that n1 is going to vary from 0 to less than capital N, and n2 is also greater than equal to 0, and n2 is greater than n1, then our valid pair exists, then I am going to return true, otherwise return false. So this is very the trickiest part of this question. So let me submit this code and check out if this is going to give the correct answer or not. Okay. So the problem is very simple and of type basic number theory. So if you have any doubts, do not forget to mention in the code description or in comment section of the video. And also I have mentioned my code in the description section of the video. And I will ask the viewers to like this video, share this video, and do subscribe to my YouTube channel. Also join my Telegram channel present in the description section of the video. Thank you for watching this video.